Hi everyone, welcome back to my next quote I guide my life by. These are quotes I live my life by as my North Star that they tell me on a daily basis if I'm doing right or wrong, or do I need to make adjustments in my life. This is the course. Am I on course or off course? Is my life a success? These are the quotes that tell me what a successful life is and help me to judge if my life is a success. And so I hope these will provide some value to you. Take from them what works, what applies, and what doesn't, leave behind. We're going to continue talking about values, because if you aren't living for a set of values that you have determined for yourself, not that society laid on you, these are my values that come out of my heart, out of my soul, then I'm afraid you'll just wander around and have a meaningless, empty, purposeless life. That's exactly what happened to me. I just didn't know why I was alive. I didn't know what a successful life would be. I didn't really know what my personal values were. And so I was just kind of nothing, going nowhere. Just a blob, doing nothing. So I want to read one of my all-time favorite quotes. How many times have I said that now? Lots. It's from George Bernard Shaw, who was a famous Irish playwright, writer. This is an astounding quote. This is really an astounding quote. And as you listen to it, you can hear my life, the direction of my life, and all these quotes in it. It's powerful. This is the true joy in life. The being used for a purpose recognized by yourself as a mighty one. The being thoroughly worn out before you are thrown on the scrap heap. The being a force of nature instead of a feverish, selfish little clod of ailments and grievances, complaining that the world will not devote itself to making you happy. George Bernard Shaw. Now I know that's kind of rough
language.
I know. And yet, you know, that's kind of what I've been for most of my life. A feverish little clod complaining because the world didn't devote itself to making me happy. Just, and if not, you know, if that's pretty extreme, and I was probably never that bad, but I was just meandering through life without a goal, without a purpose. I certainly didn't have a mighty purpose that I was living for, something that I knew I was called on this earth to do. And so just being nothing. Being nothing, doing nothing, accomplishing nothing, not proud of who I was, not proud of what I was doing, not moving to become something, not moving to accomplish something, just existing. And so he says, this is the true joy in life, the being used for a purpose recognized by yourself as a mighty one, the being thoroughly worn out before you are thrown on the scrap heap, the being a force of nature. And so that has become my goal, to be used for a purpose, to have a goal and a plan. And when I know, when I wake up, I want to do good. And at the end of the day, I ask myself, did I do good? Did I make the difference in someone's lives? Is someone's life better today because I lived? Does it have any meaning that I lived today? And if it doesn't, what am I going to do to change that? Because I don't want to come to the end of my life and have just done and been and accomplished nothing. That's not acceptable to me. So it takes a determination. And here's the big thing. And it sounds really unpleasant, but what he says is, this is the true joy in life. And I can promise you that I have found this to be the true joy in my life, living for a purpose, a mighty purpose. What I recognize in myself, this is a purpose worth living for, worth sacrificing for, worth dying for. And a human that has that is a happy human, is a fulfilled human. Life won't always be easy. Life can be very hard. Sometimes when you live for a purpose, it can be tragic. It can be difficult. It can be painful. Sacrifice will be required. But your life This is the true joy of life. And so difficulty and sacrifice, that's what you'd pay to get the true joy of life. So there is a purpose for you, and I don't know what it is. But stay tuned, watch these videos, and we'll keep talking about them. And just discover it in your own heart, in your own soul, in your own mind. You can't find it anywhere else. That's the only place where your purpose exists, in that deep, still, quiet place of your heart and soul. And you have to get down in there and find it. And I can't find it for you. I hope you do. I can assure you that for nearly everyone, it means being a person of love and kindness and compassion. That if you will become a person of compassion and kindness and love, a life of joy will be yours. So, I hope you got something out of this quote. If you did, come back for the next one. And hopefully we'll discover new truths together. See you then.